Anki is a simple flashcard program that's free to download on Windows, Mac, and Linux. But why is a simple flashcard program 440 megabytes? As someone who remembers growing up with a 700 megabyte hard drive, I'm often surprised at how big and inefficient software is these days. So let's download Anki and find out what all is in that 440 megs. For version 2.1.35, the Mac download is currently 136 megs. Once we install that, we get an install directory of just over 440 megs. That's way too much for the actual logic of a flashcard program, and it's not like there are videos or other media that come with it, so the rest must be libraries. Let's fire up Grand Perspective and see what's taking up all that space. Right off the bat, we see a huge file that takes up 200 megs of space. It's Qt Web Engine Core, which means Anki basically includes an entire web browser. That means our simple flashcard program can run JavaScript, decode all sorts of media files, stream audio and video with WebRTC, and all the other things a modern web browser needs to do. Qt Web Engine is part of Qt, which is a set of programming tools that work the same across Mac, Windows, Linux, and more. Basically, Anki needs a lot of functionality for things like drawing the interface, text editing, opening image files, and so on. Qt provides all of this basic functionality, and it works cross-platform, so you don't have to rewrite your program for each different platform. But it means you need to include a copy of it with your program. Okay, what else is there? We have translation files, which is great for people who aren't native English speakers. A lot of software used to have separate downloads or optional components for each language, but it's way easier to just include everything in one bundle. Also, there's MPV, a media player, and an MP3 encoder, so Anki can play media files and save audio as MP3s. And, of course, lots of libraries for the programming languages that Anki is written in, Python, Rust, and JavaScript. Each of those libraries is useful, I'm sure, but libraries depend on other libraries, which depend on other libraries. In total, there are something like 50 to 60 Python packages and around 50 Rust packages, plus some JavaScript libraries like MathJax. Because of how huge Qt Web Engine is, all these packages don't make up that much of the total size, but they do add up. The last interesting file is icudtl.dat. It's a collection of data files for dealing with Unicode text across many languages, so things like word lists and character set tables. macOS definitely has all this already in some form or another, and you probably have several copies of it across your other apps that are built on Chromium, but again, easier to just bundle it. So there you go. The actual Anki code is at most 3% or so of the total package size. Everything else is there to simplify development or make various features possible. And this is how software is generally written these days. For example, instead of coding a custom formatting language for creating flashcards, just include a web browser and tell people to use HTML. Hard drive space is cheaper than ever, and users want features and ease of use, not smaller apps. Obviously, there are trade-offs, and not every programmer has the luxury of just dropping in a web browser whenever they feel like it. Software for things like automobiles and spaceships need to be lean and efficient, not some pile of HTML and Java. Anyways, hope this was interesting, and I definitely appreciate all of your comments and likes. Thanks for watching.